'Twas the eve of the first Christmas when all through Bethlehem not a creature was stirring, not even a hen. The manger was filled with straw and with hay, but nobody expected that's where a baby would lay. Mary paced the stable floor, wishing she was snug in bed, while Joseph timed contractions, carefully counting in his head. When baby Jesus arrived at last, he lay in Joseph's lap, and Mary settled down for a well-deserved nap. Suddenly, outside the stable, there was such a clatter. They sprang from their bed to see what the matter. Joseph opened the door, and as quick as a flash, in tumbled some shepherds with an almighty crash. The shepherds told of how angels put on quite a show, but there was something they were just desperate to know. When what to their wondering eyes did appear but a newborn saviour baby, the Emmanuel, right here. This is no story that has just begun. They knew in a moment he must be God's son. To seek and to save is the reason he came. And he loves me, and he'll die for me, and he even knows me by name. When I dwell on how his love for me is faster than the sky, and I think about how for my sins Jesus had to die. After all he did for me, I knew just what to do. I decided to follow him for my life, and so my love for him, it grew. At Christmas time we remember the baby Jesus who came, but on Easter we will remember the man that took all the blame. Christmas is about that, the arrival of God's saving Son. This Christmas I hope you eat lots, laugh loads, love greatly and have fun. But most of all, I hope you see how much God loves you. This Christmas, if you want him, he can make your heart brand new. Merry Christmas, everybody. Bye.